Hey everyone, Vinayak here. I've been gaming on the PS4 Pro for a few years now, and one of my controllers is exhibiting analog stick drift, which is that it would move in a certain direction even without having my hand on it. I wanted a replacement and not have to pay loads for another, so I have here the Sense wireless controller for the PS4. So let's check it out if it is good or not.
Here's the packaging. Quite nice, a box actually. The controller I ordered online had New World in the name, but the one I received has the name Sense. We have wireless controller written on the top. On the back, we have the features, which is supposed to be equivalent to what the original PS4 controller has. This is a budget controller, which works with a PS4 or even PCs and mobile phones that have Bluetooth. You can also use this wired on a PC. Two analog controls, direction pad, touchpad on top, gyro, the works. Let's open up the box. We have the manual and also the controller all wrapped up in this protective foam cover and also a micro USB to USB-A charging cable. Here's the controller, looks nice. All the standard buttons are available on this. The direction pad, the thumbsticks are quite nice. Share and option buttons are on the top next to the touchpad. And the mandatory triangle, circle, X and square buttons, which are depicted in 3D instead of the standard 2D shapes. The PS button has a home icon instead. Audio jack to listen to the game audio on a headset while playing competitively or not wanting to disturb anyone. There's a grippiness in the handle area of the controller. It feels like rubber, but it's not. The blue lines also look cool. Micro USB port to charge the device. This port is not at the standard location as found on the original controller, so you will not be able to use this device with any charging docks. Buttons on the back are the L1, R1 and L2, R2. The thumbsticks are also buttons, so the two of them are the L3 and R3 buttons. They also have a more concave dip in the center as compared to a more convex rise on the original DualShock controller. It also seems to have these dots for better grip on the analog sticks. The originals have none. The buttons are more rounded on top as compared to the more flatter design of the DualShock. Unlike the PS4's DualShock controller with a big LED light in front, this one actually has a small one above the home button. PS4 games also use the touchpad for controls in-game, and it's available on this controller. This controller can be used with a PC via Bluetooth, so let's do that first. I have a TP-Link Bluetooth dongle on my desktop. If you have not seen the review earlier, here's a card. Hold down the home and share buttons for a few seconds to activate pairing mode. This is also the same on the original DualShock 4 controllers. The Bluetooth list would show a device on the PC, wireless controller, tap on it, and as easy as that, we have paired it. The controller being a DualShock 4 clone would need the DS4 Windows application to enable using it in all games. The feel is good, buttons feel okay. Let's see if all the functions are working properly. Witcher 3 looks like it's working. The touch bar also allows us to pan around. Cool. The sensitivity seems to be a bit too much, a small tweak, and it's working well. Final Fantasy 14 works well here too. Dirt 3, the controls are granular, as is visible in the accelerator controls. The rumble feedback is also quite nice, just like the original. If you don't have Bluetooth on your PC, you can use this as a wired controller too via the micro USB cable. Now to set it up with the PS4. Just plug in the charging cable between the controller and the PS4, press the home button, and the PS4 turns on, and the controller is set up for wireless use. That's it. How cool is that? Gameplay, the controller does seem to work well with the occasional niggles, but overall is responsive. Here's Spider-Man, works well, but I noticed the controls are bad on the original DualShock 4 too, so won't blame this one on the controller too much. Gravity Rush, we have motion controls here and we can see the whole interface bob and turn as per the controller movement. This is using the gyro sensor within.
So final thoughts, the controller is fine. The buttons are a bit too soft compared to the original DualShock 4, Some people might actually like this one for that. The settings are tweakable on the PC, but on the PS4, there were a few mispresses. Not sure if it was the game or the controller, as the original controller itself is not as responsive in Spider-Man. The L1, R1 buttons are granular in control, and it is great in racing games, as you can control the acceleration by just releasing the button a little, and which is not the case on a keyboard, because a key, if you press a key, it's 100% and leave it at 0%. But this one is good granular control on the PC also. And the build is fine, and the battery also lasted similar to the DualShock 4 controller. The micro USB port being in a different location makes it incompatible with the charging docks that I have. But if you are looking for a replacement DualShock 4 controller under 3K, then this is a good budget option. If you have any questions, do write in to us at techittalkingstuff.net or WhatsApp us at 96525-7833. Also make sure to like, subscribe, and also hit the notification bell to be notified when new videos are added. Thank you for watching, and see you all next time.